Okay, students, welcome back. So in the last video, I was explaining you about applications of Willingham diagram. So now, till now, we have studied the extraction of metal oxide, extraction of metals from its oxides. So using reduction method, right? So using the reduction of some metal oxides, we have done, we have extracted some of the metals. Now here, there are some ores or the concentrated ores, the metal substances which can also be extracted using oxidation also. So that is what we are going to discuss here. So that is called oxidation reduction. Now here, extraction using oxidation method is mainly for non-metals. So here I'll consider chlorine. So this is actually you can write NaCl here, NaCl. So brine solution, so as you know, brine solution is nothing but solution of NaCl in water. Now this brine solution, from this brine solution we have to extract chlorine, we have to extract chlorine. So here this extraction can be done by oxidation. That is, in electrolysis, we are going to convert this NaCl into Cl2 and NaOH. Now here we have NaCl, but in your NCERT textbook, they have written only Cl minus, so I consider that only here. Of course, there is no problem if you write NaCl here, but one thing you have to mention, here also you should mention NaOH, okay? That is only the difference. Otherwise, no problem. So here we have Na plus and Cl minus. From this NaCl we have Na plus and Cl minus. So we have written only Cl minus here. So during the electrolysis, this Cl minus ion will be converted into Cl2. Okay. So that is what called oxidation. Okay. That is what called oxidation. So this is one of the example for oxidation method, from where we can extract elements or the metal, non-metals from oxidation method. Now, so you can remember the extraction of gold and silver. So there I have told you that the leaching of this gold and silver with CN, sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide. So I have written only one reaction. Only for gold I have written. You can also write this reaction for silver. Now here, there is gold. So you are going to convert this into a complex. Okay. Now here, this reaction, the conversion of this Au into Au plus. Here it is, oxygen state is plus 1. So here it is only Au. Okay, now we have converted this into Au plus, so this reaction is also oxidation. So here the oxygen state of Au or gold is 0, so here it is plus 1, so this is nothing but oxidation. Okay, so in the same way you can also see here also it is minus 1 oxidation state, here it is 0, Cl 0. Okay, so this is how oxidation takes place. So you can write same example for gold also. In the case of gold, you are going to convert, in the silver, you are going to convert Ag with the oxidation state 0 to Ag plus, that is plus 1. So this is also oxidation. Now here, in the case of extraction of gold and silver, in both cases we are going to apply the we are going to oxidize this metal first. Okay, so somehow after this process you are going to apply some other principles, but still one of the reaction in this process is oxidation. Okay, so that is the importance of oxidation in the extraction of metals here. Okay, so in the last video I have told you that in the coming videos we will be discussing about refining. So we will discuss refining procedure, refining of the metals. So why we need to refine this? So refining is nothing but converting the the crude metal which you have obtained in the extraction procedure in the isolation of this metals. So here after the concentration you have extracted metals, so even that extracted metal contains some amount of impurities, okay, some amount of impurities. So for getting pure metal, so if it has some impurities, you should get pure metal which contains only only the atoms of metals, okay. So that is what we are going to do in refining. So there are different techniques of refining is there, so out of which we are going to discuss six refining techniques. So the first one is distillation, next liquation, electrolysis, zone refining, vapor phase refining and chromatographic methods. Okay, so out of these six we will discuss three techniques in this video and the other three in the coming video. Okay, now here first one that is distillation. So as you I hope that you have studied this distillation in your lower classes. So distillation is nothing it is useful for metals having low boiling point. So it is not melting point, it is boiling point. Now consider a metal which like zinc or mercury, so which has low boiling point, which will boil at very low temperature. So when it boils at very low temperature, but what happens to the impurities? Impurities remain as such in the solid form only, but metals will boil. Now here as the metal boils, it is converted into vapor phase. It is converted into vapor phase. Of course you can collect that vapors in a separate container and you can get back the solid form of that. You can convert vapors into solid by decreasing the temperature. So that is the technique used in this distillation method. So distillation method is useful for the metals which have low boiling points. Remember, this is very useful in the metals having low boiling point. Example for this low boiling point metals are zinc and mercury. Okay. Now liquation. So liquation is nothing but here in the distillation we have considered the boiling point. In this liquation we are going to consider the melting point. We are going to consider the melting points. Now in the liquation we can take example as tin. Okay, so here in a slope surface like this, the solid metals were kept like this along with so these metals contains impurities and this is heated. So as I told you, metals having low melting point, so at very low temperature these metals will melt. Okay, as it melts it flows here, as it melt it flows here and you can get the pure metals here, but impurities as they were remains in solid form because they have higher melting point, so that will remain as solid. So that will remain here only. Only metal will flow, the impurities will remain in the this position only. So this is how you can separate or purify these impurities from the metals. Okay, remove impurities from the metals. Okay. Now the next refining technique is electrolytic refining. Electrolytic refining. Here we are going to do the electrolysis for the metals. Now the impure metal which we have got from after the concentration and isolation, now the next impure metal is made to act as anode. Remember, the impure metal is acting as anode and the same metal, okay, the piece of same metal is made to act as a cathode. Okay, but this cathode is highly pure, but this anode contains some impurities in it. Okay, So now this anode and cathode, they both kept in a suitable electrolytic bath containing the soluble salt of the same metal. So for example, if you want to purify copper, for example, I have considered here copper. So impure copper is taken as anode, and pure copper is taken as cathode. Now in this case, we need to keep this anode and cathode in the electrolytic bath of containing the soluble salt of same metal. So now here it is CuSO4, copper sulfate. So in this solution, these anodes and cathodes were kept. Now the reactions that anode and cathode takes place, I will write a small diagram here. Now consider this as cathode, anode. Now this is the solution of CuSO4. Okay. Now here in the anode, so I'll consider anode. So Cu becomes Cu2 plus, and with the liberation of 2 electrons. Now as it becomes Cu2 plus, so this will attracted to this cathode. So you can see at cathode, when it comes, it is converted into Cu2 plus 2 along with the gain of 2 electron, it is converted to Cu. Okay. So this is how the impurities from the copper is removed in the electrolytic refining. So in the impure copper, we can have the previous videos I have told you, during the isolation, so we will get blister copper. So this blister copper contains antimony, selenium, terbium, silver, gold and platinum. So by getting these, or the by purifying these or the separating these elements, this will make up the cost of this refining process or the electrolytic process. So this is how the electrolytic refining is done. So here, remember, impure metal is anode, the cathode is which one? It is a metal of same which we have taken as impure metal. So same metal, but it is in pure form. Already we have got already prepared pure metal is taken as cathode, and solution, the electrolytic bath containing that solution is nothing but soluble salt of same metal. So if it is copper, here we need to consider CuSO4, copper sulfate. Here it is acidified copper sulfate is taken. Okay, so this is how you can purify copper using the electrolytic refining. So in the next video, we will discuss 3 more refining techniques, that is zone refining, vapor phase refining and chromatographic methods. Thank you.